This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Henry Sweet, the 15th of September 1845 to the 30th of April 1912, was an English philologist, phonetician and grammarian. As a philologist, he specialized in the Germanic languages, particularly Old English and Old Norse. In addition, Sweet published works on larger issues of phonetics and grammar in language and the teaching of languages. Many of his ideas have remained influential, and a number of his works continue to be in print, being used as course texts at colleges and universities. Contents: 1. Life and Work. 2. Other Interests. 3. Legacy. 4. References. 5. Further reading. 6. External links. Life and Work. Henry Sweet was born in St Pancras in London. He was educated at Bruce Castle School and King's College School, London in 1864. He spent a short time studying at the Heidelberg University. Upon his return to England, he took up an office job with a trading company in London. 5 years later, aged 24, he won a scholarship in German and entered Balliol College in Oxford. Sweet neglected his formal academic coursework, concentrating instead on pursuing excellence in his private studies. Early recognition came in his first year at Oxford, when the prestigious Philological Society, whose president he was destined to become later on, published a paper of his on Old English in 1871. Still an undergraduate, he edited King Alfred's translation of the Cura Pastoralis for the Early English Text Society. King Alfred's West Saxon version of Gregory's Pastoral Care, with an English translation, the Latin text, notes, and an introduction, his commentary establishing the foundation for Old English dialectology. He graduated, nearly 30 years old, with a fourth-class degree in Literae Humaniores. Subsequent works on Old English included An Anglo-Saxon Reader 1876, The Oldest English Texts 1885, and A Student's Dictionary of Anglo-Saxon 1896. Sweet, like his contemporary Walter Skeat, felt under particular pressure from German scholars in English studies who, often stated employed, tenured, and accompanied by their comitatus of eager graduate students, annexed the historical study of English. Dismayed by the swarms of young program mongers turned out every year by German universities, he felt that no English dilettante can hope to compete with them, except by Germanizing himself and losing all his nationality. In 1877, Sweet published a handbook of phonetics, which attracted international attention. Among scholars and teachers of English in Europe, he followed up with the Elementarbuch des Gesprochenen English 1885, which was subsequently adapted as a primer of spoken English 1890. This included the first scientific description of educated London speech, later known as received pronunciation, with specimens of connected speech represented in phonetic script. In addition, he developed a version of shorthand called current shorthand, which had both orthographic and phonetic modes. His emphasis on spoken language and phonetics made him a pioneer in language teaching, a subject which he covered in detail in The Practical Study of Languages 1899. In 1901, Sweet was made reader in phonetics at Oxford. The Sounds of English 1908 was his last book on English pronunciation. Other books by Sweet include An Icelandic Primer with Grammar, Notes and Glossary 1886, The History of Language 1900, 1995, ISBN 81-85231-04-4, 2007, ISBN 1-4326-6993-1, and a number of other works he edited for the Early English Text Society. Sweet was also closely involved in the early history of the Oxford English Dictionary. Despite the recognition he received for his scholarly work, Sweet never received a university professorship, a fact that disturbed him greatly. He had done poorly as a student at Oxford, he had annoyed many people through bluntness, and he failed to make every effort to gather official support. His relationship with the Oxford University Press was often strained. Sweet died on 30 April 1912 in Oxford, of pernicious anemia. He left no children. Other interests: in Who's Who, 1911, Sweet gave his recreations as climbing, gardening, chemistry, alphabets, in boyhood, swimming, skating, European languages and literatures, in youth, writing, fishing, cycling, literary controversy, spelling and university reform, Oriental languages and literatures, in middle age, sociology, spiritualism, music, literary composition, in old age, looked forward to flying, real flying, not with bags and stoves. Legacy: Sweet has retained a reputation as the man who taught Europe phonetics. His work established an applied linguistics tradition in language teaching which has continued without interruption to the present day. A bibliography and collected papers were published by H. C. Wilde in the preface to his play Pygmalion. George Bernard Shaw, after describing Sweet, stated that Higgins is not a portrait of Sweet, to whom the adventure of Eliza Doolittle would have been impossible. Still, as will be seen, there are touches of Sweet in the play. The Henry Sweet Society for the History of Linguistic Ideas, founded 1984, is named after him. It holds annual colloquia, and publishes the journal Language and History References ABCDEFGHIJK Concise Oxford Companion to the English Language, as hosted on Encyclopedia.com AB Kunitz, Stanley, Haycraft, Howard, British Authors of the 19th Century. The H. Wilson Company, 1936, p. 598. ISBN 0-8242-0007-1 AB Sweet, Henry M. A., Ph.D., LL.D., In Who Is Who 1897-1915 London, A. Carat the Columbia Encyclopedia, as hosted on Encyclopedia.com. Further reading. Charles Leslie Wren, Henry Sweet, Transactions of the Philological Society, Volume 46, pp. Authority Control. WorldCat Identities VIAF, 25378374 LCCN, N500116066 ISNI, 0000-0001-0880-8213 GND, 117385026 Sudik, 0595050552 NDL, 0045818080